Hello and welcome back to Coding with T. In today's tutorial, we're going to learn how to add sorting inside our data tables. So to create a sort, as you can see inside the dashboard, we have a sort option over here for the order ID. By clicking on this, we are able to sort this based on the IDs. And if I'm going to go to the categories inside, we are going to create the sorting option. So we have a sort over here and I'm going to clicking on this icon. It is toggling the sort. But if we go to another sort, let's say customers, and inside the customers you can see when the sorting is not enabled, either ascending or descending, you will be able to see two arrows. This means that this column is sortable, but not these columns are sortable. So when I'm going to click on them, first it is going to sort as ascending order and then descending order. So this is how we are going to implement the sort inside tables. So we are creating Flutter e-commerce admin panel, and we are about to create the last section in which we are going to cover each and every concept one by one. These videos are very important because later on, to save the time, we might not be able to follow each concept again and again. So these are the repeating concepts. So that's why you have to make sure you watch the complete video. So let's get started. Okay, so we are inside our e-commerce admin panel and we learn to fetch different type of categories from our Firebase database. We learn how we are going to get data from the design or get the action triggered from the design, then pass to the controller, then to the repository to fetch the cloud data. Then once we have the cloud data, we convert that cloud data into the model, which is a JSON. And once we have the data mapped on a model, we return the list of the data or the list of categories in the category model and back to the controller. Then controller send back to the design. And this is what we learn. And also we learn how to display the data inside our data tables. If you're new, you can watch the previous video. So we are just going to make sure that you should be able to learn each and every concept before going to the next screens, because in which we are going to just repeat the same concepts to save the time. Okay, in today's tutorial, we're going to cover the sorting, and for that we need to go to the screens in the category, and in the all categories we have a table over here. So we are using T paginated data table. If you are new, you can watch the complete pagination videos, previous videos. Again, the link is in the description. So when I'm going to click on this paginated data table, this is what we have inside the paginated data table, and this is the complete design of the widget. So down below in the sorting section, you can see we have three variables. We talked about each of them in detail, but just for the quick review, we have sort ascending value, means if it is true, sort will be ascending. If it is false, it is going to treat the sort as descending. Then we have sort column index, that which column is going to be sorted. After that, we have sort arrow builder. This is going to display different type of icons based on the sort. If you can see, we have two variables, ascending and descending. So ascending and sorted, if the value is sorted, if it is true, we are going to return this if, and inside this if icon will be, if ascending, we are going to return this icon, if descending, then this icon. And if it is not sorted, we're going to simply return this icon. So we're going to use these two dynamic variables that we are getting inside this constructor, and we directly have those values over here. So first of all, let's go back to the controller, and as a sorting, I am going to add two things. First one is sort column index to identify that which column of the category table is going to be sorted. We will display 1, 2, 3 as column numbers, and then sort ascending or sort descending values. If it is true, means ascending sort. If it is false, means descending sort. So both are obvious. This means we just need to change these variables and they will be able to redraw the design itself. Inside the paginated data table, we first have to call our controller. So I'm using get.put category controller. It is again going to fetch the already created instance. But if you want to use category controller.instance, then you just need to make sure that before finding the already created instance of any class, make sure it is existing. Otherwise, it is going to throw an exception. So once we have that instance of category controller, we can simply use the values like sort ascending, and we will assign the value from controller.sortAscending.value, and then we have sort column index. Again, go to controller and assign sort column index dot value. Now by assigning this, we know that whenever there is change inside this ascending sort, this is going to automatically trigger the design or the design update. And if the column index is changed, this means that we will be able to redraw the design again and the column index will be updated. Now to add the sorting on top of this first category column, inside this column we have a property called onSort. sort, which is a function, and this function is going to give us two things. Let me remove this constant. So inside this on sort, we are going to receive column index and ascending sort. So call it a function. So now I'm going to call controller dot sort by name, and inside this function I'm going to pass these two things as it is. So let's create a method. So you can see this method will be created inside this controller of category controller right over here, sort by name. Now inside this method, the first thing we are going to do, we have to update our variables. Sort column index dot value is equal to whatever column index value we receive. In this case it might be 0 or 1 because we have the first index. So the first index will be automatically assigned to the sort index, and based on this table will redesign or redraw itself. It might be able to change the icon and definitely perform the sorting. So then we have same way, sort ascending dot value is equal to ascending. And now to do the sorting, we have to do the sorting on top of filtered items, or you can also do the sorting on top of all items. So we have a method called sort, and inside this method we have a function like this. We create a function like this and then add a semicolon, and inside this function we receive two values, a and b. You can name it differently, but inside this function now we are going to check that if ascending is true, then we are going to return the value by sorting a dot name, because it is a sort by name, so we have to do the sorting with the name a dot name dot to lowercase, make sure it is lowercase dot contains. This is a function that is going to compare two strings and return either 0, either 1 or 2. So then we're going to compare it with the second value, b dot name dot to lowercase, sorry, contains. Instead of contains, we have to use compare to. So my mistake, compare to is going to return, you can see, returns a negative value if this order before other means a is ordered before the other value. So it is going to return negative value, a positive value if this is ordered after other, and zero value if both are equivalent. So if it is not ascending, then simply we're going to return the b dot name first dot compare to a dot name. So it will be reversed in order, and by this way the error is gone. We are returning what is needed to the filtered items, and filtered items will be sorted based on these two values. And inside this function we are not returning anything, rather we are return means we are assigning the updated values to this filtered items, and now the filtered items updated. Okay, once this method is ready, we have also added that method over here, so error is gone. Now if you see, in the previous tutorial we added inside the category desktop, we added the OBX over here for the loading purpose. If the loading is true, we're going to display the loader animation, else we're going to display the category table. But now inside the category table, we're not talking about the loading, rather we're going to talk about that we need to update this paginated data table whenever there is change inside these two values. So let's try to add a widget on top of this paginated data table, which is OBX, which will be responsible to redraw the design. Okay, so far so good. Let's run the application. Okay, our application is running. Let's go to the categories, and you can see we have a loader, and after that loader we have all the values of the categories, and also you can see a sort option or the sort icon we have over here at the top. And when I'm going to click on this, you can see all the values updated successfully, and when I'm going to click on it again, you can see the icon is being changed, values are being changed, and we do not have any other option for the categories, for the sorting, sorry. And by this way, let's say I'm going to add the sorting option for the parent category as well. Let's remove this constant, add it over here, and this time let's say I'm going to call a function sort by parent name, keep the p capital. So let's create that function. Again I'm going to copy all these values, and inside this function again sort index will be updated, sort ascending or descending will be updated based on the selection. Whenever we're going to click on that arrow or the column header, it is going to trigger this function with the ascending sort or descending sort as true or false. So but just for the testing case, let's say we have another one function and the arrow is gone. This time we should be able to display a sort option for the second column also. So let's save it, and you can see we have two sorting options. By default this one is showing as a sorted, and this one is in the idle position. When I'm going to trigger this sort again, it is working on this sort, but now this one is ascending. by clicking on this. Now this is in descending, but again when I'm going to trigger this one as a sorted option, you can see the icons change and this one again go to the idle position. So this is how we implement the sorting inside our data tables, and the same approach we are going to use for all the upcoming videos. So make sure to grab these concepts and also the upcoming video concepts in detail. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comments. And once again, if you are new here, you can subscribe the channel and make sure to hit the bell icon to get notified for all the upcoming videos. Once again, thank you for watching and take care.